Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn about skeletal system. In previous class, we have done about the backbone or spine. What is the shape of the backbone? S shape. And with the small bones, that is 33 small bones, the backbone is made up of. And the small single bone is called vertebrae. Okay, so let's start with the ribs today. The ribs are long, thin and curved bones. And there are 12 pairs of ribs all together. And these together make a cage-like structure called rib cage. What is the function of rib cage? It protects the heart and lungs. These all bones together meet at a point called sternum, which is also called breastbone. And at the lower end, there are two floating ribs. They are not fused, so they are called the floating ribs. Okay. So, if I ask you what is the another name of breastbone, you can say that it is a sternum. Clear the layer? And how many pairs of ribs are there in the rib cage? There are 12 pairs. What is the function? To protect the heart and lungs. Next, we are going to see about the limbs. What are limbs? The arms and legs of our body, commonly called limbs. Arms are called forelimbs or upper limbs, and legs are called hind limbs or lower limbs. Then each arm has three bones, humerus, radius and ulna. Humerus, the upper arm, the bone present in the upper arm is called humerus, and the two bones present in the lower arm are radius and ulna, and they all together connected to the wrist, not humerus but only the ulna and radius. Even your wrist, palm and fingers have a small bones joined together. Now let's see here the modification of forelimb of different animals. It's humans, cat, bat, horse. Modifications are different but the functions are same. Okay. And modified, how they are modified? According to the adaptation of animals. Let's see about the hind limb. Now your each leg has also three bones. Upper leg has a bone called femur, which is the longest bone in our body. The lower leg has two bones called tibia and fibula. Okay, and these tibia and fibula are connected to the ankle. And very interesting fact about the forelimbs and hind limbs, that total number of bones in hind limbs and forelimbs are total 33. And the limbs are attached to the girdles in our body. When you put your hand at the back, you will see that we have a pair of shoulder. Okay, it is also called as pectoral girdle. So your upper limbs are attached to the backbone with the help of pectoral girdle. And the lower limbs are attached to the backbone with the help of hip or pelvic girdles. Okay. Now, your leg bone, that is the tibia and fibula, as I told you, they are connected to the ankle and toes. Clear? So, now here, I think it is very clear how many bones are present in your upper limbs and lower limbs. Now, let's see something about joint. Now, what is joint? A place where two or more bones meet, they are called joint. And these are held together by a strong connective tissue called ligaments. Okay, we cannot move our body with the help of joint. And we have more than 100 joints. Okay, so these joints are of two types. movable and immovable. Now I am teaching, that means I have some movable joint, my lower jaw, that I am moving, that is a movable joint. And the joints which cannot move, suppose your skull, is called the immovable joint. Now, on the basis of shape and function, the movable joints are. So, the movable joints, that means we allow the movement of bones in various directions, whereas the immovable joints do not permit movement of bones. They simply join the two bones. For example, the bones of skull and pelvis. Now, on the basis of shape and function, movable joints are of four types: ball and socket joint, hinge joint, pivot joint, and gliding joint. So now we'll see what is the function of ball and socket joint. So first we are going to see about ball and socket joint. Okay, so here you can see this is a round ball shaped bone, and here it is a socket shaped bone. In this way the ball and socket joint are fixed. Now, what is the function? They allow movement in all direction. Now suppose you have seen your shoulder, you can move in all directions. Okay, your hip, okay. Then just see the another joint, that is a hinge joint. It allows the movement of bones in one direction, that means your arm, your hand, fingers or knees. When you try to move them, is it, you can either see this side you can bend, but at the back side you won't. Then see the pivot joint. This is the pivot joint, and it is found in between the backbone. It is at the end of the start point of the backbone, and skull is connected with the two vertebrae, and it allows you to move sideways, upward and downward. Clear? This is a pivot joint. Then at last you see the gliding joint. It allows bone to slide against each other. Suppose the wrist and ankle, we try to adjust sometime, is it? So we can glide them. Okay, and where it is found? It's been between any two vertebrae of the backbone. Clear till here? I think in joint you have no problem. If problem, you can ask me.